Hey folks, it's Joe Hanna back again with another edition of Insincerely Joe. This time I have an open letter to whining Cavs fans. So here it goes. Dear whining Cavs fans, look, I get it. You're upset, you're worried, you're confused. Many of you are just plain freaking out, okay? The way this Cavs season ended just plain sucked. I'm still as disgusted and bewildered as all of you are about the Game 5 LeBrockle, okay? Combine that with LeBron's free agency and all the rumors, and it's basically a perfect storm of fan angst, okay? But here's the deal, Cavs fans. You need to stop acting like such pussies, okay? Begging LeBron to stay, the videos, the websites, the whining blogs, the bake sales, and the candlelight vigils, cut it out, all right? Collectively, you're acting like a pathetic dude that's dating a girl that's probably a little too hot for him, all right? You're driving by her house late at night to see if she's home. You're asking your buddies, do you think she'll stay with me? Do you, huh? You're checking her Facebook status obsessively, looking for clues as to whether or not she's gonna leave you, all right? Stop it, stop it. You're making our city look pathetic, all right? LeBron is gonna make his decision one way or the other. All right? Nothing we do at this point is going to make any difference. In fact, all the begging and all the pleading might actually drive him away. Okay? If he stays, great. We'll build the team around him. They'll try again. We'll cheer our hearts out with our fingers crossed, and maybe we'll win a title with LeBron. If he goes, they'll start over. All right? The Cavs will survive, and despite what you may have heard, Cleveland won't shut its doors forever. All right? In the meantime, the pleading and the neediness just looks pathetic and weak. Be strong in your manhood, Cleveland, and confident in the size of your market. The Cavs and the fans have nothing to be shamed about for how they treated His Highness, okay? If LeBron leaves, that's on him, and we will find another superstar to love, maybe even one that'll get us past the second round. This has been Insincerely Joe.